That's only on meetings and convention type websites that will use that. Revolutionize Your Weekend is more for that on the leisure side, the tourism per se. You heard about, I think, before, we talked to you about doing an underground guide to Spartanburg. This is in a partnership with Hub City Writers Project. It's already underway. It won't be completed until December. It takes a long time to put this together, but that's going to be a great project. It's all the different things. If you have suggestions, Betsy Teeter, the folks at Hub City Writers Project, welcome all, any. I think it's going to be a great differentiator for us. And I'm not telling anyone at the state level yet. I think once they have maybe a first draft done, we'll let them know that we've got the first underground guide in South Carolina. One other question, or one other point on the underground guides, I have another publication that we're working on. Again, just to try and fill in some void, it appears that the CDB were happy to do that again in partnership with Parks, Team Spartanburg, other entities. One thing that's missing is a facilities guide. When we're going to trade shows and conferences and even sales calls, what do you have for facilities there? Tiger River Park is tremendous, but there are other parks and other facilities, as many of you know, the public can use, people can rent. So we're going to put together a facilities guide, and this is really a very rough mock-up that our local ad agency put together for us this morning. We'll probably do a couple hundred pieces of these. We can adjust it as new facilities come online. We see this as an opportunity again to try and get the word out.
The annual work that I have around town, I'm hearing a lot of good buzz about the things going on in Spartanburg County, and thank you for being an ambassador and your staff, and we appreciate it. And as always, the door is open here at our committee, and anytime you can give us an update, we're glad to hear it.
We're good. Thanks, sir.
Thank you, Chris. Appreciate it. Okay, the next item is to receive information and action in reference to Arcadia Mill number one. Mr. Burke, Mr. Bullard, and Mr. Rogers of Rogers Law Firm to present.
Thank you for giving us the opportunity to speak with you today. My name is Chris Rogers. The tall gentleman here in the front is Pace Burke, and this is Tab Bullard over here with him as well. Pace and his partners own the Arcadia Mill, and I say mills because there are two of them. And let me just tell you, I'm on his development team, and I'm the attorney that represents Pace and his partners. But there are two mills. One of them has already been developed. They have developed it, renovated it into loft apartments, and it's called the Mayfair Loft. Into loft apartments while maintaining the historical character. We actually got a variety of tax credits on that project. It's very expensive to renovate these old textile buildings. State textile credits, state historic credits, federal historic credits, and we were here 5 years, 4 years ago, got the what we refer to as the Baileyville tax, special tax assessment, which is why we're here today. I'm gonna let Tab talk more about that, but the second mill, Arcadia Lofts, or what will be Arcadia Lofts, we know, that one is right down the street from Mayfair, and it sits there empty. It's about 250,000 square feet. It's a safety hazard. It's a blight on the community because it's just sitting there empty with growth around it and vagrants in and out. Pace really wants to develop that property, and the county, the officials that we've met with, wanted to develop that property as well. The first project was an enormous success. Mayfair Lofts is full, it's rented up, it's doing well, and it's, you know, there's been a lot of other economic activity in the community as a result of it. But what we are here to ask for tonight, Tab's going to tell you more about this, and then Pace is going to wrap it up for us. Because of the economic decline that has occurred since we initially developed Mayfair, and the difficulty in obtaining loans and financing, in order to develop the second mill, the Arcadia Mill, we are here to ask for some additional help with the property taxes under the what's termed the Bailey Bill, which is a statute that authorizes the county to give us a special property tax assessment on historically rehabilitated properties, which would basically defer the additional tax that results from the increase in value for a period of years. And we would be asking for 20 years on the new development, which is the maximum allowed, and an additional 10 years on Mayfair lofts. We've already got 5 on that, but we would be asking for an additional 10. And that is really to support the numbers so that we can get financing for that second project. All of this would be contingent on us developing the Arcadia Mill, the second mill. I'd also want to mention, I've been speaking with the county attorneys, and we thought it was a good idea to ask that an amendment to the current ordinance, the special assessment ordinance, be adopted to allow the county council to adopt or to extend the special assessment period by resolution, because the current ordinance does not specify that. It just says that, it says you can do it, but it doesn't say how. So we would propose a very simple amendment to the ordinance that would allow the council to do that by resolution, just to clarify that. So that said, I'm going to hand it over to Tab. He's going to give you a little presentation.
Thank you, Chris. And as you said, my name is Tab Lewis. I've worked with Paceburg, the developer of Mayfair Lofts, for a number of years now. And we appreciate y'all having us and listening to us and considering our requests. With that said, I believe everybody has a presentation handout that was passed out prior to the council meeting starting. And we've got a presentation here for you to see as well, too. In front of you, what you have is sort of a rendition from another historical consultant that Pace has hired. This is what we propose doing to Arcadia Lofts, the second project. To kind of go into a little bit of history, in 2005, Pace and his partners purchased these two mills with the intention of developing them into loft-style apartments. The first project that I'm sure most of you are aware of is Mayfair Lofts, and the second one, the project on the right, is the second Arcadia project, Arcadia Lofts. Prior to the purchase of these two lofts, they had been both sitting vacant for more than 10 years. Arcadia Lofts, as it sits right now, is still vacant. Both projects, we feel and have heard from various other people within the county, they're both visible and emotional blights on the region before the renovation of Mayfair and Arcadia as it sits now. We all know that older projects sitting vacant for years can be havens for vandalism, crime, drugs, and can have a negative impact on the surrounding property values. And the longer they sit, you could eventually see environmental issues come to bear with these older lot projects as well, too. You've got lead-based paint and asbestos that could, you know, leak into the surrounding areas and cause substantial damages that may require substantial remediation, if not dealt with properly and in a timely manner. So these mills, sitting as they were and as Arcadia is now, we feel they're costing the economy monies without bringing any true benefit to the region. So before Pace bought them, it really was time to either demolish or work with the private industry to redevelop. And that's why Pace came in, took these both down, because he has a specialty in taking projects like these. He has the vision to develop them into what you see now over at Mayfair. The renovations on Mayfair began in 2005, completed in late 2007. The total investment after complete renovation of Mayfair was more than $8 million. If anybody's been to the project, you can see that was a very well spent $8 million. Critical to the success of Mayfair, as it will be for Arcadia, is what Chris touched on previously. In 2004, the South Carolina Bailey Bill was amended. The Bailey Bill provides incentives for developers of historic eligible properties for property tax abatement, determining an issue at the local government level for as long as 20 years equal to the appraised value of the property at the time of preliminary certification, that is, before you begin rehabilitation. Also critical at state level is what is called the Textiles Community Revitalization Act. This provides for a fully applicable state historic tax credit equal to 25% of the qualified or actual rehabilitation expenses at qualified textile mill sites. Both of these incentives are very important for attracting historic tax credit investors to smaller historic rehab projects. Looking at them, you may not think they're smaller, but in the world of historic tax credit investments, $2 million in historic tax credits aren't that much. There's a question.
Chad, let's break it down on that part right there.
Yes, sir.
Take the Bailey project. What did that mean to y'all with that?
The Baileyville project for Mayfair Loss, it was about $80,000. Where's that money?
What's the deduction of property taxes per year?
Between the values, we're paying about $27,000 or $30,000 a year. Probably on that particular project, I think it's probably about a 50% decrease. Now, what we did on that project is that we came in a little bit late, so at the time of certification, we had already begun renovations before we found out the process. So the tax board came in and appraised the value at its current condition, which was about a 40% complete project. And from that, from the expenses moving forward, they agreed to allow us to have a payment on those particular expenses. And not to kind of butt in, but we had anticipated at that time during that market to take 5 years, and we didn't want to ask for more than what we needed. We had planned to condo those units, and then of course through the economic downturn, we now have decided that we're going to become, and I'll talk real briefly about a group that came in and did an analysis for us, but we're now going to be long-term apartment developers in that area and no longer do the condominium concept. The market's not there. So you know, the last meeting, we didn't ask for more because we didn't need it, except the bottom fell out of the market. And
we didn't think we would need it, but you know, we now see that it's in this area, it's more important to provide this type of service. And then instead of being some condo developer that comes in and throws additional single family homes on the market when single family market is already kind of overbuilt in some areas. I don't know if that answered your question, so I apologize if it didn't.
Well, as we look, I mean, again, spent $8 million. I mean, that project, I mean, that plant was sitting there. I travel by that, both those facilities, you know, twice a day, and I've been doing it for 24 years. I know what it was before. I know what it is now. I know what you did in the Bailey deal. You really have given that. It's almost a shot of adrenaline just to look outside the tracks to see how nice that is. And like I say, other developments and private community has come from that. I also know right down the street where the corporate office, you know, used to be a big mill, how bad that is.
Right. Yes.
And the longer it sits, the worse it gets.
Exactly.
And what I'm trying to get a handle on is, because this is the first time we've heard this information. I read in the packet, you know, our information, Josh met with our attorney back in February. So y'all have been working a long time, but we on this committee just got this information.
Yes.
Last week, and not even this, we just got this today. So I'm trying to get a handle on what will that Arcadia mill cost you? What do we pay, what do you have to pay taxes now? And how can we help you get the same level? I mean, in just easy English and easy math.
Yes, well, as of right now, what we're asking for would be essentially a freeze in taxes for Arcadia for 20 years.
Well, that mill right now is being appraised at maybe $150,000 or $200,000. Now, what's interesting, and let me break in, is that the $8 million that we invested in Mayfair, the appraised value is actually somewhere around $4.5 million. So what's happening is the federal government and the state recognize that you cannot go into these buildings and make them economically feasible without some incentives from the local, state, and federal level. And so when we sell those tax dollars, tax credits, we're forced to pay them down on the debt to make it where it can cash flow, and that's where it really works.